Hi, thanks again for tuning into 1MinuteDigital.com. Today we're working in Photoshop and I'm going to show you how to desaturate an image, or most of it, so that part of that image pops out in color, just like this one. Those shoes pop out and look really nice when you desaturate the rest of that color image to give them their own little pop. Okay, so the first thing that we do is zoom in. Now you can use your magnifying tool here in your toolbar to zoom in, but just so you know, I use Command Plus and Command Minus to zoom in and out, so that's how I do that so quickly. And it saves you a lot of time, trust me. So zooming in, in your toolbar, go find the old-fashioned looking pen tool tip right here. It's called the pen tool, and we want to select the Freeform Pen Tool. That gives you a little pen icon, and now basically you can start anywhere. Just start drawing around the shoes that you want to cut out, and pretend like they're a razor or scissors, and just cut out the shoe as you go. Now when you're zoomed in like this, you're going to have to stop and move the image to save your wrist, so that's okay. Just stop drawing, hold down your space bar, and you get a little hand icon. Now you can move your image up and down where you want it. It's a lot easier than using these sliders at the bottom. So once you've zoomed out a little bit or moved it where you want to, you still have your pen tool. Hover over the line you just drew, and I know it's hard to see, until you get a little slash icon that pops up. That tells you you're right where you left off, and you just click there and keep drawing. So take your time, don't have to rush, don't have to go too slow, oops, and don't worry if you get a little bit outside the line or inside the line, because we can fix that later. Just cut out the shoe as best you can, and when you need to stop, just let go, press your space bar, move your image, hover over the line till you get the slash, and pick up where you left off. Just start drawing. Now I am using a bamboo Wacom tablet. You can also do this with the mouse. It is a little harder. A Wacom tablet is a wonderful thing. Just keep going. And when you get close to where you started, which was here, you'll see another little icon pop up that tells you you're at the end of the line. You're back where you started, so let go. And it's really hard to see, but you have cut out these shoes. You've actually made a pen line around the whole thing. Now, if you can see here, It didn't actually listen when I went around the heel of the shoe, and it's cut me off, and it cut off part of that image. We want to fix that. That's okay. Just go back to your pen in your toolbar and click on the Add Anchor Point tool. Zoom in a little bit, and now pick a part of the line and hover over that, and see you get a little plus icon. Click there, and now it turns that into points that you can drag. Hover over it till you have a white arrow. Click and just drag it to where you need it to be. And you can manipulate the entire line here. And you can get really close and fix all the little spots like this one where you kind of messed up, and keep it real close to the image that you want to cut out. So that looks pretty good. So zoom out a little bit. And now we have points around this selection. What we want to do now is actually make it a proper selection by creating a working path. So go to Window, Paths, and it's actually created for you already. It's called Work Path, and it's a little blobby looking shape there, but what that shape is the shape of these shoes that we just cut out. So with the Command key selected, click inside this gray square, and now it turned those points into these little marching ants and made it an actual selection. Great! Now what we're going to do is head over to Select Inverse. And what that just did, you can't really see it, but it flipped the selection. We originally had the shoe selected, we did Select Inverse, and it made it select everything except the shoes. It did a flip, it flipped the selection and selected everything outside of that area, sort of like in Superman 2. And so now we have everything selected but the shoes. Now head over to Image, oops, making sure you're on the right layer. That happens all the time. Click on the layer that you're working on. Go to Image, Adjust, Desaturate, and boom, the rest of the image is in black and white. That simple, folks. And now it looks really nice. The image just pops out, and you can do this with absolutely anything using that pen tool. The pen tool is your friend, and this is a lot easier than trying to use the like the elliptical marquee to cut things out, or the lasso, and especially better than the magic wand tool. That is forbidden. But you can do lots of things with a pen tool. So thanks again for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.